welcome back to this week's episode of Tiger Beat. Stay tuned for hilarious shower thoughts, awesome commercials, and much more.
Who has two thumbs and loves to party? This girl. Last Friday, FCCLA hosted the Spring Fling Dance. FCCLA kiddos sponsored the Twin Day, where students dressed up alike. Prizes were given to three couples that won. The Spring Fling is and was the place to get your groove on and party it up.
Now let's go to Senior Spotlight starring Eli Bloom.
Eli Bloom is the son of Laura and Mike Bloom, born on April 3, 1998. He is the youngest of all nine of his siblings and half-siblings. He enjoys hanging with friends or going skateboarding. Another thing he loves is listening to music and plucking his guitar, ukulele, jaw harp, and blowing wind through his didgeridoo. His favorite high school memory has been hitting up the different skate parks with his pals. He plans to finish up high school and go on to college at SWIC. One hot day in the summer, he rode his bike to a friend's house with a tinfoil hat on his head. His friend's mom was very concerned.
Hello, I'm reporter Cassie Nelson, and we're going to play a game today. It's called 3 Truths, 1 Lie. In case you fans didn't watch last episode, I'll explain what it is. We're going to have four people participate. Three people will tell the truth, and one person will tell the lie. You have to figure out who is lying. The four people who are participating are Mr. Malowski, Miss Mongar, Miss Breach, and Leah.
I went to Italy with 12 other people to visit the Statue of David.
When I was four, I had the chickenpox.
One time early in my teaching career, I accidentally wore my skirt backwards to school. My baby was young. I was very tired. Who knows? Maybe there was some sort of time change. But yeah, it happened.
I almost attended the University of West Alabama.
Did Leah really go to Rome to visit the Statue of David? Did Miss Breach have chickenpox when she was four? What about Miss Mo? Did she wear her skirt backwards one day? And finally, did Mr. Malowski plan to attend Alabama College? Well, let's figure this out. Do you guys really believe that Leah went to Rome? Because she really did. Miss Breach was a liar. Heh. Liar, liar, pants on fire.
Hey everybody, I'm Tiger Beat reporter Sam Trost. Here's this week's riddle. What goes up and down but doesn't move?
Eating staples is probably not good for your health. Highways are not used for llamas. Punching a brick wall is not recommended by doctors to fix a headache. If you jump off of a building head first, you will probably die. You cannot see through a mirror.
Up next, we have Rebecca Cross with Senior Spotlight.
We have many good memories together, lots of sleepovers, staying up late, making bad music and karaoke, and Rebecca.
On December 28th, 1996, Rebecca Noel Cruz was born. Rebecca's parents are Roger and Sherry Berger. She has many older siblings that love her. These siblings are Jesse Cruz, Hannah Keller, Levi, Isaac, and Daniel Cruz. As a child, Rebecca created many memories with her siblings. One of her favorites was when she would go into her siblings' room and bother them nonstop, like any five-year-old would. Rebecca has a busy high school life. She is always doing something. Rebecca was in cross-country, track, speech and drama, and solo ensemble for vocal. Rebecca said her favorite high school memory was when she got kicked out of the library, but then changed it and said it was when she got to be evil for the school play. And, of course, hanging out with her cross-country fam. Rebecca's future plans are to attend SWIC for a year and get her associates in the human services, then transfer to university for counseling.
Good luck, Rebecca, in the real world. We wish you lots of luck. Miss Mo!
Yeah!
This week, Miss Green will be telling you all about her education.
Hi, my name's Tiffany Green. I am currently the second grade teacher here at Lenox. I believe I started kindergarten in 96, I believe. And I started at Bedford Elementary, and I stayed at Bedford until I graduated my senior year in 2011. I also took college classes my senior year at Iowa Western in Clarinda, And then I continued to take summer college classes that summer. Then in the fall of 2011, I started my freshman year at Morningside College. For the following two summers, I also took college classes, and then was able to graduate college a semester early, so I graduated in December of 2014 from Morningside College. And then I moved home in December, and right away after winter break, I started substitute teaching in January. And I substitute taught in different towns around the area, such as Mater, Lenox, Corning, Diagonal, Preston, Bedford. And then I was hired right around a year ago now and started teaching here at second grade at Lenox.
Congratulations, Miss Green. You've been in education for 20 consecutive years.
My name's Emily Adams, and I'm proud to introduce my bando buddy Bennett. That is Hannah Bennett to you. She's an awesome gal.
Keith and Jackie Bennett welcomed their brown-eyed girl, Hannah Dawn Bennett, into this world on January 26, 1998. Hannah has two siblings, a brother, Sean Bennett, and a sister, Nicole Fry. Hannah is also the aunt of her sister's two kids. She enjoys spending time with family. Her hobbies include reading, listening to music, and driving around with friends. Throughout high school, Hannah has been involved in basketball, softball, track, volleyball, 4-H, speech, drama, student council, annual staff, and band. Hannah hopes to continue playing her trumpet in the Iowa State Marching Band. She plans to attend Iowa State University to explore in a communication major.
Hi there, this is Nicole Fry. I'm Hannah Bennett's sister. I cannot believe she's graduating in just a few short months. Time has flown on by. I am such a proud big sister and cannot wait to see what the future brings for her. I love you very much, Hannah, and I wish you the best of luck.
Next, we have the prom update with Miss Boshi.
The juniors are working very hard to plan their prom this year. They are looking through magazines like Prom Night and Anderson's to decide on the decorations and getting ready to order them very soon. They've also planned what they're going to be eating and who the photographer is and who the DJ is for the dance. They're also working on raising money for their after prom, so they have a lot of exciting things happening at this time.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Boshi, for that amazing prom update.
Are you a farmer in need of seed? Or fertilizer? Well, Tagold Co-op is your answer. Tagold sells seeds, fertilizers, and chemicals. Tagold even does custom applications. Tagold Co-op is located on 701st East Van Buren Street in Lenox, Iowa. You can find someone in the office Monday through Friday between the hours of 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. The office number is 641-333-2202. If it is after 5 p.m. or on a weekend, you can call one of the guys. Remember, behind every farmer is a great co-op team. Make that team Tagold.
Now on to sports and weather for the week.
Hi, I'm sports reporter Chelsea Hokeson. The High School Winter Sports Awards were held on Friday, March 11th for bowling and basketball. Participants and letter winners were recognized by their coaches. For bowling, the following received conference and district awards. Seniors Alan Hoffman and Haley Balls were named to the first team in the Pride of Iowa, and they were named to the All-District Honorable Mention team. Corey Egger and Micah Riggs both were named second all-conference. The following people received honorable mention: Elijah Briggs, Emily Powell, Kaylee Cole, Doug McLean, Brett Myers, and Dylan Mendez. For basketball, Spencer Brown was named to the first team, while Caleb Anderson and Sam Donaldson were named to the second team. Congratulations to our teams and coaches.
And action! I'm Mother Girl Lord!
And I'm Mother Girl McKenna!
And spring is almost here!
Wait.
Yeah, we're good.
Weather girl.
No, wait. We still have to go, do trivia. Oh, yeah, we'll be right back after this commercial.
Taylor County Choppers is a full-service salon. They are located on 115 North Main Street in Lenox, Iowa. They are owned by Jennifer Diamond and LaDania Tripp. Their telephone number is 641-333-4393.
Hi, this is Taylor County Choppers. We are here Monday through Friday, Saturdays by appointment. We're generally here from 9 to 6 in the evenings. We have a tanning bed. We have clothes in the back. all kinds of cuts, colors, waxes. We have a nail lady too, Lee Hill. And come see us for your haircut, color, and new spring style.
The answer to the riddle is stairs.
Yo, we're back with some trivia. Hit me up, Kenna. When was the first Iowa State Fair held? A, 1863, B, 1789, or C, 1854? 1854 is the correct answer.
Hi, I'm Tiger Beat sports reporter Tyra Stokes. High school track started on Monday, February 29th. Let's go get an update from the coaches.
Hi, I'm here with high school girls track coach Mandy Stokes. Tell us a little bit about how your preseason's going.
We have 12 girls out for track this year. There are 2 seniors, 3 juniors, 5 sophomores, and 3 freshmen. And they have been working really hard. It's been nice to get outside last week with the nice weather. So we're excited to get the season going.
Tell us how the ISU indoor track meet went.
On Monday the 14th, we went to Ames and ran on an indoor 300 meter track. There's over 60 schools there, and a lot of the schools are big schools. And so it was a good experience for the girls to see lots of good competition. We had some decent times, and we have some things we need to work on.
This is the first time in 10 years that there'll be a home lights track meet. How do you feel about that?
We're pretty excited about that. April 18th is our co-ed meet here at Lenox, and it'll start at 4:30, so come support the Tigers.